Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today we are going to discuss on how to install latest version of Python, that is Python version 3.12.3 on a Windows operating system. So you might be having assignments from your school or college regarding Python and you want to install latest version of Python to start working on your assignments. So if you are, you know, that kind of student, or if you just simply want to install Python, so you can totally watch this video, and I can promise you, if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things and you'll be able to successfully install your Python. So please do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always comment. I'll try my best to help you. Now, to install latest version of Python, you have to first simply go to favorite browser. You have to just simply search over here, Python download, and hit enter. And immediately you'll be able to see this www.python.org as a first search result. So you have to click on this download Python. So this link, and I'm going to put right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, you can see latest version of Python version 3.12.3 is available to download. So you have to click on this download button to start downloading our Python. You can see it is rightly started downloading, and it is downloaded. To install, you have to just simply click on this installer. And you can see that our install Python 3.12.3 installation wizard is rightly open. Let's first minimize our browser. So here the first thing that you need to do is you need to click on this add python.exe to path. That is really an important step. So you know, don't forget to check this. And after that, you need to click on this customize installation. So here under optional features, all options need to be checked. So you need to check this for all users also. And then you need to click on next. And then under advanced options, you need to again check this install Python 3.12 for all users, and all other things you need to keep it default, and click on install. And immediately it's going to ask you about administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. You can see our setup, you know, is rightly progressed. So it will take some time, in about a couple of minutes. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Python setup was successful. So you can just simply click on close. So now that you know that our Python is rightly installed, you can always go to search and type cmd to open our command prompt. So let's verify whether Python is successfully installed or not. So here on command prompt, if you just simply type Python and hit enter, you'll be able to see latest version of Python 3.12.3 rightly shown. So if you see this similar type of message, then all that basically means is your Python is successfully installed. So it's time to write some code. So for that, let's go to search again, and this time type idle. So that will show you Python idle 3.12 version. So just simply open that Python idle, and you can see that our Python idle shell 3.12.3 is actually open. So here you can write some code snippet, like let's say you want to print something on our console. So if you type something like hello, hit enter, you can see the output hello rightly shown. You can also create a new file. So let's, you know, create a new file and give something like a equal to maybe 15 and b equal to maybe 5, and let's say you want to print summation of these two number. So a plus b, that is the output that you want. So 15 plus 5 20 need to be printed. So just simply go to file and click on save as. So let's save the file on our desktop. So I'll click on desktop over here, and I'm going to, you know, give the file name as sum. Alright, and I'm going to click on save, and you can see that our sum.py file is actually saved over here. So here is the file. So now just simply write this much code snippet and go to run and click on run module. You can see the output 20, the desired output, that is 15 plus 5 20, is successfully shown on our console. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of Python. You can create new files, you can start writing your code snippets, and you can run that on our console. You can also use PyCharm IDE. Previously I have showed you how to install PyCharm, so that also you can follow. Alright, and also please don't forget to subscribe our channel. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.